Yeah.
Wow, that was great. Most people around here know that you can go sledding at White Sands National Monument. But there are a lot of other wild things too. It's the only place like it on Earth. It is truly unique. My name is Eugene Ibarra and I'm a park ranger here at White Sands. I'm going to tell you about where the white gypsum sand came from. Picture me at the bottom of the sea, because 250 million years ago, where I'm standing was at the bottom of the sea. I can't even imagine that many years ago, can you? Our sugar-like sand is made of gypsum. Most people know gypsum as a rock or a crystal. Gypsum is rarely found as sand. The huge amount of sand here is a result of the sea covering this area for millions of years. Wow! I just jumped ahead 180 million years. The sea is long, long gone. It is now 70 million years ago when the Rocky Mountains formed. That jump puts me 30 million years ago. The land that White Sands is on now sinks down about 9,000 feet. The area that sinks becomes a tularosa basin and becomes like a bathtub without a drain. That means that the water that comes into this basin stays on this basin until it evaporates. There is no river to carry the gypsum away. This special bathtub without a drain is one of the very few basins that was covered by an ocean for hundreds of millions of years. It is another wow! Now we're about 24,000 years ago. The climate was cooler and wetter. A huge lake covered a big part of the Tularosa Basin. Mammoths, giant camels and sloths and dire wolves lived here. They lived in a much and wetter and colder place than what the Tularosa Basin is like today. All the rain washed the gypsum from the mountains down to the huge lake and it stayed there. Turns out there was a lot of gypsum in that water. That's a wow! Around 10,000 years ago, the huge lake dried up. That left behind a lot of selenite, which is gypsum in crystal form. Wow! Selenite is so soft, it can be scratched by a fingernail. The crystals break into smaller and smaller pieces. Eventually, they are small enough to be blown by the wind. 7,000 years ago, the gypsum dune started to form. Wow, that's a lot of sand. Here is the biggest wow for today. The combination of this land being under the sea, the land becoming a bathtub without a drain, the huge lake collecting lots of gypsum that washed out the mountains, that huge lake drying up when the climate got hotter, and the selenite crystals being broken down into sand. All of this has resulted in the biggest gypsum sand dune fill on Earth. No other gypsum dune fill even comes close in size. Wow! So now you know there's a whole lot more to White Sands than sledding. And there's even more to learn about this unique place. The special plants and animals, all kinds of amazing things. Hope your class can visit us soon, either on a field trip or by computer. We can promise you you'll have fun. See you later!